welcome each and every person to Passion and Purity. Good Friday, evening of worship, a time of the word, a time of prayer, a time of thanksgiving. Christ did it all for me. And I am Jermaine Johnson. With me this evening is
Ronique Mills.
Oh my God. Ronique, did Christ do it all for you? I just want to hear from you.
I'm telling you, every cent, every penny, everything that I could not have done, I'm telling you, he paid it capital, bold and underlined, A-L-L. He did it all.
Come on. Just hashtag that right now and say, Christ did it. Hashtag, Christ did it all for me. And that's what we're saying. And we're saying to persons, welcome. For those joining us on Zoom, those on Facebook, those on Instagram, whatever platform you are on right now, you're in for a treat this evening, today, Good Friday. Ronique, we were talking recently in a Passion and Beauty session, you know, I think it was this morning, and persons were saying, you know, what's the meaning of Good Friday, you know, to him or her. And for me, when I see Good Friday, I see hope that, you know, God knew that there would be a Sunday morning. The devil didn't know, but God knew that that was planned. And I see hope. What is this for you, Ronique, when you know Good Friday comes around? What's that feeling like for you?
It's just like an awesome time of reflection, just thinking back on, you know, the whole sacrifice that Christ would have made, because trust me, it wasn't an easy feat. If we think that we could have done any kind of sacrificial things for our friends or our families or even for ourselves at this time, trust me, Christ beat everybody to it. So it's really just a time of reflecting on that great sacrifice. For me, it's the highest form of love. So it's all about love.
Wow, that is so awesome. And I'm saying, I know that there are persons out there. And what we want to do this evening, we want just to spend a time of worship with us. And you are going to interact with us. I want to type in the Zoom chat, you know, what it is that Good Friday means for you, what Christ has done for you. Just share the testimonies. You are on Facebook. Also, we want you to do that. And so some of the comments that will come up, we will share them throughout the program. If you are on Instagram or YouTube, do the same, because indeed we are here. So, Ronique, what are we going to start off with today as we go further in today's session?
Right, so we could never start such a wonderful session like this without first watering the soil of the hearts of those of us who are going to receive the seeds of God's word. So at this time, we're going to invite Auntie Verona, and she's coming with the opening prayer.
Father, we come together on this special occasion to celebrate what you have done for us, an unending celebration that enraptures our hearts with gratitude. Lord, you are good. We come to sing and dance and talk about your goodness and your ever prevailing and abundant mercies towards us. Thank you for dying on Calvary's cross, Lord, a sacrifice that generates our forever applause. As we come to you with hearts of praise and extend our love to you, Lord, we pray that you receive our worship. For those who are weary and downtrodden with care, we pray you will lift every burden and grant beauty for ashes and the oil of joy for mourning. Lord, for those who have not yet come into that awesome fellowship with you, Lord, we pray that this celebration of you will be a royal invitation extended to each and everyone who will find it too captivating to resist. Lamb of God, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Triumphant One, be glorified in our midst as we cast our gaze on you, the only one who is the center of our affection, the only one who merits our adoration. We exalt you, Lord, now and forever. Amen.
Amen. What an awesome prayer indeed. We exalt you, Lord, now and forever. And for those just joining, you are in for an evening of this time of word and worship and passion and purity. Somebody must be wondering, you know, who are these persons, passion and purity? I just want to say that we are indeed a registered charity and non-profitable initiative. And we started in 2008. And this movement was started by Mr. and Mrs. Andrew and Donnie Norman. right there at the Woolmer's Girls School and Woolmer's Boys School, respectively. Now, Ronique, I think you were at that first, very first conference. I was not at the conference. I heard about it from an awesome young lady, Vanessa, came to church the morning, Sunday morning. I was like, Uncle Jermaine, something happened. Tell us a little bit, you know, for those that weren't there. You know, what was that morning like for you?
Yeah, man, you don't have to think. I can confirm that indeed I was there. yes, it was the first conference was at the lower school auditorium at Woolmer's Girls. And I can tell you, we were all very excited. The auditorium was buzzing because this is our first, you know, conference, kickoff, Passion and Purity. And I mean, the presenters were wonderful. To this day, I can still remember some of the messages that were shared, one of which being about the importance of the music that we listen to, you know, and the effect that it has on us. And I think that's something that really transcends throughout generations or the ages, because that message is timely. Like whenever it is preached, that message is so timely. Especially even now, because a lot of our young persons are so warped up in that industry, and it's very important. My pastor spoke about recently about your ear gate, you know, guarding your ear gate. What is it that you're listening to? That message stuck with me. I remember one of our teachers, Mrs. Christie, being one of the presenters. I remember the book. Oh, it was really awesome. So trust me, if I left Woolmer's, how many years ago? I won't tell you. But if I can remember so much, just these bits and pieces that stuck with me, just imagine how many persons were, you know, impacted. And those persons now, you know, having grown into adults and are gone across, you know, different sectors of society, they carry that with them. That's how the seed of God's word really spreads and has such a wonderful nationwide and worldwide impact. And that's the impact of Passion and Purity. It's nationwide, it's worldwide. I mean, God is big.
Amen. I just thank you so much for that experience and talking about nuggets. And again, this evening we are focusing on the record. Great is your mercy. And for those who have been following us, we have been looking at Thy Will Be Done as a movement. In terms of the Lord's Prayer, we are right at Thy Will Be Done, and we are talking about God's mercy. And what a day, Good Friday, that we can focus on the mercies of God. And we also want to say that Passion and Purity has grown over the years to become, you know, a family movement. And so it is, Ronique is here, and she has grown, and she's giving back. And we are saying to all the persons out there who have benefited from Passion and Purity, there is space for you. You are here. We need to reach the next generation with the word of God. And so at this time, we're going to be moving on. And we have a wonderful family. This is the Browns family. And they'll be coming with an awesome account of the crucifixion, part one. And that's taken from St. John 19, verses 1 through to 24. And that's the King James Version. So do be blessed by this awesome, awesome family, the Browns family, with their rendition of the awesome account of the crucifixion, part one. Be blessed.
Today's scripture reading will be taken from John 19, verses 1 to 24. Then Pilate therefore took Jesus and scourged him, and the soldiers plaited a crown of thorns and put it on his head, and they put on a purple robe and said, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they smote him with their hands. Pilate therefore went forth again, and saith unto them, "Behold, I bring him forth to you, that ye may know that I find no fault in him." Then came Jesus forth, wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe. And Pilate saith unto them, "Behold the man."
When the chief priests therefore and officers saw him, they cried out, saying, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" Pilate saith unto them, "Take ye him and crucify him, for I find no fault in him." The Jews answered him, "We have a law, and by our law he ought to die, because he made himself the Son of God." When Pilate therefore heard that saying, he was made more afraid, and went again into the judgment hall, and saith unto Jesus, Whence art thou? But Jesus gave him no answer. Then saith Pilate unto him, Speakest thou not unto me? Knowest thou not that I have power to crucify thee, and have power to release thee? Jesus answered, Thou couldest have no power at all against me, except it were given thee from above. Therefore, he that delivered me unto thee hath the greater sin. And from thenceforth Pilate sought to release him, but the Jews cried out, saying, If thou let this man go, thou art not Caesar's friend. Whosoever maketh himself a king speaketh against Caesar. When Pilate therefore heard that saying, he brought Jesus forth and sat down in the judgment seat in a place that is called the pavement, but in the Hebrew, Gabbatha. And it was the preparation of the Passover, and therefore the sixth hour, and he saith unto the Jews, Behold your king. But they cried out, Away with him! Away with him! Crucify him! Pilate saith unto them, Shall I crucify your king? The chief priests answered, We have no king but Caesar. Then delivereth he him therefore unto them to be crucified. And they took Jesus and led him away.
And he, bearing his cross, went forth into a place called the place of a skull, which is called in the Hebrew Golgotha, where they crucified him, and two others with him, on either side one, and Jesus in the midst. And Pilate wrote a title, and put it on the cross, and the writing was, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews. This title then read, Many of the Jews, for the place where Jesus was crucified was nigh to the city, and it was written in Hebrew and Greek and Latin.
Then said the chief priests of the Jews to Pilate, Write not, the King of the Jews, but that he said, I am King of the Jews. Pilate answered, What I have written, I have written. Then the soldiers, when they had crucified Jesus, took his garments and made four parts, to every soldier a part, and also his coat. Now the coat was without seam, woven from the top throughout. They said therefore among themselves, Let us not rend it, but cast lots for it, whose it shall be, that the scripture might be fulfilled, which said, They parted my raiment among them, and for my vesture they did cast lots. These things therefore the soldiers did.
This is a reading of a portion of God's holy and awesome word. We honor it by saying, Thanks be to God.
God. Amen. What a sobering word. That reading. An awesome family. And you heard everyone, right? You heard the different voices, the young ones and the older ones. And that was such a sobering reading. How was it for you, Ronique?
Yes, I'm just thinking about, you know, how for some persons, you know, we could always say we know the account of Christ's crucifixion, but when you really sit and go through the scriptures word for word, it's just so much emotions, and it really just goes back to the point of it was such a great show of love, just how much Christ had to endure for us, you know, and that's why it's very important for us to take this time to really reflect, because guess what? All the paths, right, that lead to the Lord are full of mercy and they are full of truth. And he made us not only to receive this mercy, you know, through the atonement of Jesus Christ, but that we, in understanding all of this and with the love that was shed abroad in our hearts, that we could become the vessels here on earth to carry this mercy and truth right through the world. Remember what I said earlier about worldwide? God is big. Yes. Yes. Carried right through throughout the world, wherever we are.
And for persons who are wondering, a way that is in the scripture, it's just Psalm 25, verse 10. You know, all the paths of the Lord are mercy and truth unto such as keep his covenant and his testimonies. So if you are keeping the covenant of the Lord, you are walking and following the Holy Spirit, indeed, God is going to lead you into mercy and truth. Just open your heart and allow the Holy Spirit to just lead you into what it is. And because we know that God is just worthy of everything, Ronique, we are just going to go in a time of ministry, right?
Amen, right. So what better way to carry us through into all of this than a dance entitled The Worthy of It All, and this will be brought by the RGPA dance group. Please be blessed by this awesome ministry.
Lord, to you we give our everything, our hearts, our all shall forever sing in celebration of this awesome liberty that Christ has given to us for all eternity. Day and night, night and day, and beyond the realm of time and space, our ceaseless worship like incense will rise in joy and love before thy glorious face. Lord, you are worthy of it all.
Arise, day and night, night and day, let incense arise.
Hallelujah. Come on. I want to see you get excited right now. You're worthy of it all. I know we are excited right now because we're saying that, God, you are worthy of it all. You are right here at the record. Yes, great is your mercy, Lord. And we know the record, we're going to read a scripture shortly. You know, 1 John 5, verse 11 to 12. For this is the record. Yes, that eternal life is in his Son. And if you have the Son, you have eternal life. And so we are saying to somebody today, whatever social media platform you're on right now, we are inviting you. Get somebody in. This is about the love of God. And when you have something, you want to share it. Is there anything you like so much, Ronique, that you know you just want to share with somebody else? Anything at all. It could be food, whatever it is. I'm thinking of something right now.
If it could be what?
Food, anything at all that you love so much that you just want to share with other persons.
Could it be a fruit?
Yes, it could be. Yes, tell us something that you love.
Well, in this time, you know, they say we don't drink coffee, tea at manga time and wash the pot and turn them down. Mm-hmm. It's almost like my reality.
So, oh, so you love mangoes, and I can tell you, Julie Mangoes, is that so? Yeah, you see, so Julie Mangoes is so precious to Ronique, and I know that she would see it as a prized possession, a prized food, but the love that you have so much inside of you, and God has indeed shed his love abroad, you are going to give that away, because it's something precious, and that is what God has done through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ. He gave his best. And so that we can be a part of that family, the family of God. And so coming up,
interject here briefly, Jeremy, before you go on back to the scripture, you know, eternal life is in the Son. The record, the record has already been set, you know, it can't change, you know, it's already set. There is no tweak. There is no adjustment. It's already running, right? But here is the catch. The only way we can be part of this record, the only way we can be part of this studio party, since you're using musical terms or whatever, only way we can be part of this is if we have the life of Christ within us. And we don't want to miss out on this record that has already been written. It's there, you know. All we did, our only thing that we need to do now is to ensure that we have Jesus Christ, the life of Christ,
Oh my goodness. So we must believe in that new commandment that the Lord indeed has given us. And that's John 13, verse 34 to 35. And says, Jesus said, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another. I give you that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. But by this, all will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. So we are able to love through the power of Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit.